So, it is the video you have all been waiting for. Some of you, most of you, a lot of you. My braces 101, my braces update. Let's get into it. Hello guys, what is up? Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, subscribe to my channel. If you would like to see more videos from me, if you want to see my face more. I also have a bunch of social media links down below if you guys want to check out my Instagram. I'm mostly active on my Instagram. I have my Spotify, my Pinterest, all the jazz down below. I've never said that saying before. As I mentioned, I'm going to be talking to you guys today about braces, about my progress, my experience so far, pain, flossing, you name it. Just a bunch of braces stuff for today's video. I feel like I'm experienced enough so far to give you guys all my advice, my tips, my experience. I know a lot of people who watched my braces video, the first one I did when I got them on, really wanted this video. So yeah, with that being said, we're just going to get started. Let's do this. Okay, so I'm gonna have timestamps down below in the description box just so it's easier for you guys to navigate through this video if there's like a certain part you wanna see. So I'll have that down below. The first thing I'm gonna talk to you guys about is my experience with braces so far. I've had them since August 13th, 2020, so about 5 to 6 months. Even though I didn't have them for a long, long time, I've seen so much changes already in my mouth. My teeth are so much straighter than they were. It's crazy to look back at my progress photos, which I'll show you guys in a few minutes. Just so crazy how much my teeth have already moved. Throughout these couple of months, I've definitely experienced a lot with my mouth changing, my mouth moving. So for the first week of having braces, my mouth hurt so much. I couldn't even eat a little donut. Right after they put them on, I really didn't feel any pain until I went to eat a couple hours later. They definitely do feel super weird when they're in your mouth because it kind of like, it's an extra little bit of space that pushes on your lips. It's super weird to talk. I also had a lisp the first couple of weeks of having braces. This video here, if you go back and watch it, you can hear I talk super weird because I'm not used to talking with the braces and navigating how to move my lips, if that makes sense. Because I had my teeth extracted as well, and then a week later I had braces put on, my mouth was just going crazy and it was just not used to anything that was happening. So I had my jaw locked for basically a month and I couldn't open my jaw all the way. Now it's totally fine, but I was so scared that something was wrong. And my dentist literally told me I was fine, but I was still very scared. And because I had this like locked jaw issue, which apparently is really common when you get your teeth extracted, sometimes your jaw locks, especially because my mouth was going through so many changes. I couldn't even open my mouth wide enough to eat a hot dog, so I had to cut up having a hot dog. I really just could not eat a lot of hard foods either. Cut up eating a hot dog and I couldn't eat it fully. I couldn't eat a burger. Just a big burger, I had to cut everything up. So that was definitely really challenging and frustrating just because it's so annoying when you can't open your mouth wide enough. You don't even understand, guys, you do not understand. Obviously because I was already in pain from the braces and then from my teeth extraction, I was eating a lot of soft foods. I literally had so much freaking pudding, butterscotch pudding, chocolate pudding. I had a lot of soup, basically just really, really soft food. I think after about a week and a half is when I stopped having pain, and I only had to take Tylenol a couple times. It wasn't super bad. I know a lot of people say it feels like you got punched in the mouth, and yes, it does. If I even hit a fork on my tooth by accident, it hurt so bad. I'm trying to see if I touched base on all my first experience things. But yeah, the first week was obviously painful and I had to take Tylenol. I eventually did obviously get used to it and get used to talking with it. There is time. I'm still, because my teeth are always continuously moving, that my lips sometimes get caught on a bracket. That bracket is no longer here, it's here or something, and then my lip gets stuck on it. Basically, my experience so far with them, they haven't been bad. Most of the time, it's just I have braces on my teeth, I don't feel pain at all. It's just, you can't even really see them, so that's really nice. Obviously, if you guys have any questions on like anything that I didn't answer in this video, comment them down below, I will answer them. So next, I'm gonna talk about my gaps slash my teeth extraction, because I did have to get 4 teeth pulled out. Quick little rundown, my top jaw was a little teeny bit smaller than my bottom jaw, so I didn't need jaw surgery, thank God. But instead, they decided to pull out 4 teeth. The 2 teeth up top had to be pulled out, and then to match it, they pulled out the bottom teeth as well. Because my jaw kind of went like this over, my bite was really, really weird. So they pulled the teeth out so that all the teeth could move back and expand. I have noticed that my smile is much wider. I feel like my face shape is way better because my teeth were so crooked. After looking at my progress photos, I can definitely tell, especially even seeing me talk in videos from when I first got my braces on, the gaps are definitely closing. I don't know if this is gross to show. Also, sorry my braces are stained. I had freaking curry chicken bad idea. As you can see, obviously my gaps are smaller. I don't even know if you can really see it that much. They've definitely gotten a lot smaller, which is nice. With the healing, that also took about 2 weeks to like fully heal, and I would just do swooshes in my mouth with salt water, just basically what your dentist instructs you to do. I can still eat normal food. I was scared I wouldn't be able to eat chips, but those are fine. You just kind of have to be gentle within the first month of eating because your gaps are so big, and then over time they get smaller. It becomes habit, like you don't even notice. They definitely are still something I'm insecure about, just because when I talk to people, not so much now, but definitely when I first got them, I was scared that people can only see my gaps. And when I laugh, you can see the side of my mouth, and so you could see the gaps, and it just obviously would make anyone insecure if they had two big gaps in their mouth. They're harder to see, which is nice, and it's only been like 5 to 6 months. Hopefully by August, they're closed. Yeah, the gaps aren't that bad. The healing wasn't that bad. I already talked about it in a video, so if you do want to see that, I'll have it linked down below. But I did talk about the whole process with them taking out my teeth, so you can watch that if you want to know how that went, and I go just more into detail. So the next few things I'm going to talk about go hand in hand with the closing of the gap. I think around December or November, I'm pretty sure it was November, is when I got rubber bands. I'm gonna go get them to show you guys. So I had rubber bands just for a little bit of time. Honestly, I thought I was gonna have them for the rest of the time I had braces, but I only had them for probably a month. Cover the address, but they look like this. I got a little thingy to put them in. You can see just like this little, I don't know if I have any left. My nails look really bad. Please ignore that, but that's like the rubber band right there. What the rubber bands do is they pull in the gaps to try to close them. I don't know if it's moving my jaw exactly or everything. I don't know the science behind it, okay? I am not a dentist, but I know that they gave me these for my jaw and my gap. The rubber bands definitely are painful when you first get them because it is pulling on your mouth. I know the biggest tip is to wear your rubber bands. It's not hard, guys. Just wear the bands. I would wear the bands and then eat food with it, which is probably gross and bad, but I heard that if you are eating food with it, it will make them close faster. Don't count me on that though, but I would obviously change bands after I ate my food. I would just basically try to have my rubber bands in for as long as possible so that they would close faster, and it worked because I only had them for like a month, and my orthodontist noticed a difference already. Basically, my biggest tip is to wear your rubber bands and then constantly change them, because if you wear the same rubber bands for like 4 days, which is disgusting, please don't do that. But if you wear them for too long, they're gonna wear, if that makes sense, and they won't be as strong as they were when you first put them in. So just make sure you're changing them all the time. There was definitely days where they would not hurt at all, and other days where they would hurt a lot, depending on how much my teeth were moving, but they were put in place to close my gaps. The next step after the rubber bands are power change. So I recently got power change actually at my last appointment. I'm gonna try to insert a picture here of somebody with power change so you can see, but instead of it being an elastic on each bracket, it is one huge elastic that intertwines within all of them, and it is to close gaps. I don't know the exact difference with the power chains and the rubber bands as to what exactly it's doing, if it's closing it or just moving the teeth. I don't really know. Power chains are hefty and mighty, y'all. These hurt so much. When I first got these on, it was the same pain that I had when I first got my braces on, so they definitely hurt a freaking lot. That also means that they're working. I don't know how long I'm gonna have the power chains on for. I don't know if it's for the rest of my braces process. I don't know if you can see the elastic. It goes right through past the gap. But yeah, power chains definitely hurt, so if you have to get them, I am warning you, they are so painful. Okay, so next I'm gonna talk about pain and tightening. I get my braces tightened every 6 weeks. I think it depends on your teeth and everything, but I get them every 6 weeks. They change the wire, they change the elastic, so every time I get them tightened, I get so excited because my teeth look so white because of my new elastics. It's just this little click, click, click thing, and then they're tightened. It's really, really quick and easy. Other than my power chain appointment and the time that he gave me rubber bands, my teeth really wouldn't hurt when I got them tightened. I know a lot of people say it's like detrimental pain, but mine really didn't hurt. I don't know why. Obviously, there were sore. I could still eat cereal and hard food. I don't know if it's just I have a good pain tolerance, but definitely hurt with the every elastic band, rubber band thingy. Okay, so the next thing I'm gonna talk about is broken brackets. I didn't think I would ever get my bracket broken. I thought I was being really gentle, but I've had them broken 2 times so far, and it hasn't even been a year. Basically, how it feels to me when the bracket is broken is obviously it's loose, and then it moves, and it feels like a loose tooth when it, that's the only way I can describe it. It's so gross, but I was literally eating Doritos and then my tooth felt weird and I was like, oh, my bracket broke off. I still don't know how I broke my bracket. bracket, but just try to be really gentle when you're eating hard food. The other time I broke my bracket, I was flossing, and I think I just yanked it or something, and my bracket broke off. So the next thing I thought I would talk about is cuts and wax. I have not used wax a lot, but I've only used wax a couple times because my teeth obviously are moving and shifting and everything. Sometimes my lip, like I mentioned, will get caught on it, and that will be annoying, so I'll put wax. First couple weeks of having braces, my mouth would get so cut down here and up here, and I would use wax because my mouth wasn't used to it. I think at this point now, my mouth is used to it. So far, I haven't got an immense amount of cuts. Maybe I used more than I thought, but this is how the little case looks, and the wax, you just take it out and you roll it and put it over your tooth. So next was flossing. Flossing is so, so, so important. I actually heard a fact. I don't know if it's a liable fact, but I heard that the more you floss, something with like water flow, or I don't know if that's just for a water flosser, but apparently it makes your braces close faster, whatever. I don't even know if that's true. Food gets stuck in your teeth so much. Guys, I always get food stuck in my teeth because I just like eat like a pig, and so you need to make sure you floss. It is gross. Sometimes you'll just be chilling after you eaten food, after you swish your mouth with water, and then suddenly there's like a piece of food you feel in your mouth. It's gross. Food will literally get caught everywhere and anywhere, so I think it's really important to floss. This box looks really ratchet, I'm sorry, but this is a floss I use. It is the Oral-B Super Floss. If you don't have braces and you're gonna get them, basically you literally have to like weave them through your teeth. So you go up and then you floss, you take it out. It's just good for your gums as well, and it's really important to have good gum health when you have braces on, so floss. So now I'm gonna do a little slideshow of my braces progress photos that I have so far. I don't know if I'm gonna include the ones that show my gaps, just because those are so ugly of my mouth, and I'm like really insecure about up close in my mouth. This is my progress photos. As you can see, little by little, they get better. And then if you see the last photo from the first day, the first time I got braces, to the most recent progress photo, you can definitely see a big difference. My mouth is definitely a wider smile. I have just, like, you can see more of my teeth. And those ugly vampire fangs are no longer sticking out. So that's my progress picture so far. I can do another video if you want to see more. So I'm going to quickly go through some frequently asked questions that I've been getting in my other video. And then I did a poll on Instagram where I told you guys to ask me all the questions you have. So I will go through that one after. You know, I had a lot of comments on this video. This one, if you don't know what I'm talking about. So I did get some questions about the process before I got my braces on and how long it took. It kind of all depends on you and how fast you want to do everything. I had my first consultation and then everything shut down because of lockdown. Steps that I had to get before getting my braces on when things opened up again. I had to get 2 x-rays. I had to get a panoramic and a cephalorraphy. I don't know. 3D one around my whole mouth, a one that they can see all my teeth, just a bunch of x-rays so they know what they want to do with your teeth. After getting the x-rays, they had to do moldings so that they can see where they want to place the braces. Fun fact, I don't have braces on the very back 2 teeth. They said normally those don't need any work, so they just didn't put any on there. The moldings, which are not as bad, I know a lot of people say they're super uncomfortable. It's really just gross because you have a lot of clay putty in your mouth, and it's gross. After that, I had an appointment where we talked about finances, so how much I'm gonna pay for them, how much I'm gonna pay for them monthly, boring money stuff, and you sign papers. And then after, for me, because I had to get my teeth pulled out, I had to make an appointment at my dentist to get my teeth pulled out, and then after that, I made an appointment to get the braces put on. So lastly, for this video, I'm going to be answering your guys' questions that you asked me on Instagram. Okay, so the first question I have is, what food have you not been able to eat since braces? This kind of goes along with another question that asks what food stains your braces. I personally try to stay away from food that stains my braces just because I am on camera a lot and I take pictures a lot, and I just, like, people will see my teeth. One of the main foods that I have had to stay away from, and I learned from experience, is Kraft Dinner. Kraft Dinner is made with turmeric, and turmeric is so staining to braces. I had chicken with turmeric in it, and it literally stained my braces so bad, and I didn't think about it. Do not have Kraft Dinner if you have clear braces. A lot of staining foods, that's the main one I can think about. I still have tomato soup. I just brush my teeth after, and it's not that bad. But they say that you can't have popcorn and apples and carrots, or hard carrots and hard foods, basically things that will break your braces. One thing I can't eat that I really wanted to eat a few months ago was a candy apple. Those just look so good, and I know that it would break my bracket if I tried to eat that, and it would just be a mess. First thing I'm gonna eat when I get my braces off. Okay, so the next question is, how long are you gonna have braces for? My treatment is for 18 months, but it could be longer or shorter depending on just how everything goes. But if everything goes smoothly, it's 18 months or less. Do you ever wish you would have gotten traditional braces? I actually don't. There was times where I did get annoyed that my braces were getting stained. Other than that, I pretty much really like that they're clear. It's nice because when I'm on video, you can't really tell. I like them. They work the same. It's just like getting stained is annoying. I lived through it, so. Do your friends / family ever forget you have braces on? I don't know. I know my little brother forgot I had braces on because one time I was talking to him and he was like, wait, you have braces? And I was like, dude, I have braces. So the next question is, how often does it hurt? I kind of answered this already, but when I get them tightened, sometimes it hurts, the power chains hurt, and then I'll have like random times where my teeth will hurt or one single tooth will hurt. How excited are you for the end result? I am so excited. I watch videos where people get their braces off and they just have beautiful teeth. My teeth have been my biggest insecurity since they were crooked. So I am just really excited to be able to smile and not feel insecure and be in pictures and like be okay to smile with my teeth. Why don't you get colored braces? So because I have ceramic braces, I don't know if I can get colored elastic bands. I just personally like having clear ones. Like I mentioned, I'm on camera a lot. Do you still eat popcorn? Hell yeah, I still eat popcorn. I try to refrain myself, but I literally love smart food popcorn so much. What meals do you avoid? Okay, one time I had ribs and it was too messy. So I do not eat ribs anymore. The next question is, how much are they? So this kind of depends on your braces that you get. Only ceramic braces are more expensive, but I didn't get charged extra for them for cheaper. And I think in general, because I was paying for my braces instead of my parents, they gave them to me for cheaper. At the time, they're $7,000. I only pay $4,000, and then they split it up into monthly payments. Depends on your dentist, though. Depends on your situation. Mine are only $4,000, which is really good compared to $7,000. I've been to like 2 or 3 different dentists where I got different consultations, and this was the best one. Foods you're told not to eat but eat anyways. So popcorn, low-key still eat hard vegetables. I just like really eat it back here. I chew gum, guys. I chew gum. I will never not chew gum. If we get stuck, you just have to have skill with it. Are you happy with your progress? Yes, I'm so happy with my progress so far. So much more confident than I did. Just like even watching my videos, I'm like, thank God my teeth are getting straighter. How long do you need to have them on? From today, I think I only have a year left of braces. How much money do you get from the tooth fairy? $2. Okay, I hope you guys enjoyed watching today's video. I hope this helped you in one way or another. Hopefully I didn't talk too much. If you guys do want to see more kind of braces update videos in the next couple of months, let me know. I will do that. I love you guys so much. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye.